has always been a confusion between data science, big data, and data analytics. Most of us don't know how exactly they differ from each other and what are the similarities between them. This is Neha from Edureka, and in this session, we will refresh our understanding and concepts that are related to data science, big data, and data analytics. So let's take a look at the topics to be covered in the session. First and foremost, I will tell you what is data science, big data, and data analytics. Next, I will explain you the roles and responsibilities of each of them. That is, what does a data scientist, big data professional, and data analyst do? After that, you will see various skill sets required to become a data scientist, big data professional, and data analyst. And at the last, I will take an example of Netflix and explain you the individual job responsibilities and how do they join forces in achieving a goal. So let's get started with the very first topic, what is data science? It's a combination of different fields like mathematics, statistics, programming, machine learning, and other such related concepts in order to understand and analyze business events with respect to data. Next, it also involves to solve the problem in various ways to arrive at the solution. Not only that, but it also has an ingenious way of capturing data that is not captured before, and then involves cleansing, preparing, analyzing of this data, and at the last, it also has the ability to look at the things differently. So this is all about data science. Now let's move further and see what is big data. It refers to the large amount of data from various sources and in different formats, like we have audio files, video files, text files, JPEG, and many more. And the traditional data processing system are incapable to deal with the huge amount of unstructured data. And it is expressed in terms of 5 V's, that are volume, variety, veracity, velocity, and value. Now let's see what is data analytics. It is all about discovering useful information from data to support decision making. And that involves inspecting, cleansing, transforming, and modeling of data by using qualitative and quantitative techniques. Now, to understand the further distinctions among them, let's take a look at the responsibilities of the different professionals working in these three fields. So at the first, let's see what does a data scientist do. They perform an analysis to discover insights from the data. They use various advanced machine learning algorithms to identify the occurrence of a particular event in the future. And that's how they predict the future based on past patterns by making use of artificial intelligence and machine learning algorithms. Next, they examine and explore the data from multiple data sets and also identify new business questions that can add value to the business market. And they also involve in finding hidden patterns, correlations, market trends, and other useful business information from the data. Now let's see what does a big data professional do. They architect the distributed system for all the data that is collected and then provide security, scalability, and concurrency. And they build large-scale data processing system to store and process huge amounts of unstructured data. And then they process the data using various big data tools like Hadoop, Kafka, Spark, Hive, and also ensure that the network connectivity is up and running. Now let's see what is the role of data analyst. In simple terms, data analyst translates numbers into plain English. The job of a data analyst is to take the data and use it to help companies to make better business decisions. They acquire, analyze, and process the data and then find insights and solutions for the captured data and create data reports using various reporting tools like MS Excel, Tableau, and many more. So by now, you all might feel that the role of data scientist and data analyst are almost similar, right? Not to worry, I will explain you 3 points to make a better distinctions among them. First, data analysts are the one who do the day-to-day analysis stuff. But the data scientists have what ifs, like what if there is an inflation in the market or what if there is a financial crisis. These kind of situations are dealt by data scientists. Next, data scientists explores and examines data from multiple disconnected sources, whereas a data analyst usually looks at data from a single source like the customer relationship management system. Next, a data analyst will solve the questions given by the business, while a data scientist will formulate questions whose solutions are likely to benefit the business. Now, I hope that you got a clear idea about the differences between the data analyst and a data scientist. Since the responsibilities required in each of these fields is clear to you, let's understand what are the skills required to become one of them. So at the first, let's take a look at the skills required to become a data scientist. To become a data scientist, you need to possess a number of skills. Like to build statistical models and find insights on the captured data, you need statistical and analytical skills. In order to predict the future based on past patterns, you need data mining activities and correlation techniques. You should understand what is machine learning and advanced machine learning techniques like deep learning. You should have an idea about different machine learning techniques like supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. As programming is base tool for data science, you should understand and have in-depth knowledge of programming concepts. Let me tell you why R coding is essential for data scientists. First, R is popular and easy to learn language, and it is also used in data wrangling, specificity, and visualization. And that's the reason a data scientist needs to have in-depth knowledge of SAS and R coding. Apart from these skills, you also need to have a knowledge of big data tools, data visualization, and reporting tools like Tableau, Power BI, etc. So these are the skills required to become data scientist. So what are the skills required to become a big data professional? First and foremost thing is to master big data tools like Hadoop for storage and processing, Spark for real-time processing, and many other tools that falls under the umbrella. And one should be well-versed to work with huge amount of unstructured data. There are no such prerequisites for learning big data, but the knowledge of programming, SQL, or scripting would be a plus point. Also, you should have knowledge about business skills and visualization skills to represent the data. Let's take a look at the skills required to become a data analyst. You need to have a thorough understanding of data warehousing concepts, and you need to be familiar with computer software and tools that include scripting, query language, knowledge of spreadsheet, and basics of statistical language. And also, you should have an idea about programming and big data tools. In this figure, you can see that there are few skills that overlap each other, like we have statistical and analytical skills, both in data scientist and in data analyst. But the priority that the data scientist requires statistical and analytical skills is of high priority than compared to data analyst. Similarly, programming concepts are essential and is a base tool for a data scientist. But for big data professional and data analyst, they should have an idea about the programming concepts. Likewise, big data professionals should master all the big data tools. But for data scientist and data analyst, they should have an idea and knowledge about the big data tools. Jobs in these three fields are quite high in demand, which in turn rewards you with a fat paycheck. So what is the salary prospect? According to PayScale, data scientist is a lucrative career choice in the United States with an average salary of $125 million per year. A top-level data scientist with extensive experience in the industry can earn as much as $148 million a year. And this is one of the highest paying positions in the entire IT industry. Next, the salary prospect for a big data professional is around $97,000 per year. Again, the salary prospect depends on the profile. Like the average salary for a big data developer may be around $95,000 per year, whereas for a big data architect, he might earn around $115 million per year. And the average salary for a data analyst is $66,000 per year. Now let's come to a part where we will understand how we garner the benefits by combining all three of them together. Let's take an example of Netflix and understand how data science, big data, and data analytics join forces with each other in Netflix. First, let's see the role of big data professional. Here we have huge amount of unstructured data that is generated from Netflix. And if we try to process this data using the traditional data processing system, the processing will not happen. Due to this reason, big data professional creates an environment using various big data ecosystem tools to store and process the Netflix data. Now let's see what is the role of data scientist in Netflix example. Let's try to understand how to optimize a Netflix streaming experience with data science. First, understanding the impact of quality of experience on user behavior. User behavior refers to the way how user interacts with a Netflix service. And data scientists use this data to understand and predict the behavior. And predictions can be based on two factors, one, rebuffer rate, and the second one, bit rate. So what is rebuffer rate? It is nothing but how often a playback is interrupted. And bitrate refers to the quality of the picture that is being served or seen. If the bitrate is low, then it defines a fuzzy picture. So based on these predictions, quality of experience can be monitored on user behavior. Let's see how to create personalized streaming experience. So just tell me, how do we use data to provide the best user experience once a member hits a play on Netflix? One approach I would say here is to look at the algorithms that run in real time or near real time once the playback has started. And it should also determine what bitrate is being served and what kind of server is being used to download the content. For example, I can say a member with a high bandwidth connection on a home network could have very high different expectations and experience compared with the member on a low bandwidth on a mobile device or a cellular network. By determining all these parameters, one can improve the streaming experience. Next, what is optimized content caching? A set of big data problems also exist on a content delivery side. The key idea here is to locate the content closer to our members to provide better experience. And by analyzing the behavior of the member being served, one can optimize the decisions around content caching. Now let's take a look at how to improve the quality of content. To improve the user experience, one should also improve the quality of the content, that is the video, audio, subtitles, closed caption that are all part of a movie or a show. And Netflix receives the content from the studios in the form of digital assets. And they are then encoded and quality checked before they go live on the content servers. In addition to the internal quality checks, we also receive feedback from our members when they discover issues while viewing the particular video. By combining member feedback with intrinsic factors, data scientists build models to understand and predict whether a particular piece of content has a quality issue. And then they use machine learning models and text mining techniques to improve the quality of the content that goes live. They also use the information provided by the Netflix members to close the loop on quality and replace the content that does not meet the expectations of Netflix members. So this is the role of a data scientist to optimize the Netflix streaming experience. Now let's see what is the role of data analyst in Netflix. Basically, a data analytics is one of the important subsets of data science. It is a helper to data scientist. Let's take a look at how data analytics is used in Netflix to drive the success. Here we have different users who comes up with their choice to watch a video on Netflix. Each of these users has their own choice and preference for a video. So what does the data analyst do? Data analyst orders a Netflix collection to create a personalized profile for each of the member. But the same row for each of the member has an entirely different selection of videos. Assume that person A and B has the same choice of video, but person B and C has again different choice of videos. So based on the choices of video by users, a data analyst creates a different user streams. And then the data analyst picks out the top personalized recommendations from the entire catalog by focusing on the titles that are top on ranking. And by capturing all of the events and user activities on Netflix, they pop out the trending video. Data analyst also sorts your recently watched titles and estimates whether the member will continue to watch or rewatch or stop watching, etc. Apart from that, the data analyst can also predict the time when you watch the video, where you watch, number of searches, ratings, the time you pause, repeat, rewind, and many more. So this is how data scientists, data analysts, and big data professionals join forces together to increase the revenue of the company. I hope you have understood the differences and similarities between data science, big data, and data analytics. I hope this video was interesting. Thank you and happy learning.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!